Hi and welcome. Now today let's continue our journey on the stock music licensing field. And today I want to share my experience with you on another platform. It is a hybrid music licensing platform. Why I'm calling it a hybrid music licensing platform? Because his main activity is not to license music, but to license stock footage, HD and 4K stock footage. They are entitling themselves as the largest community, the largest platform. They are claiming of having the majority percentage of the market in this business. The stock and the music licensing business is something complementary, so it's not the main activity. This platform is Pond5. Pond5 is really the most well-known platform on the internet for music contributors. If you want information about Pond5, you just have to type it on YouTube and you will have plenty of information about Pond5. There are people who are teaching you on YouTube how to sell, how to be successful on this platform. And they are even selling you online books, materials, where they will teach you how to become a successful audio contributor. From my point of view, it's totally BS. I do agree that you can teach somebody how to create maybe a composition specially for stock music. You can teach people, and there are people who just do not know that for stock music you have to create music differently, like you would create for an artist. You can teach somebody how to create music, what is the importance in when you are creating stock music. There are things that you have to know when you are creating stock music, but teaching you or guaranteeing you that by following those rules you will have licenses on these platforms is a big BS and nothing more. I started to upload on Pond5 my portfolio at the end of the May until now. I was and I am uploading material on the daily basis. Now, I really have to tell you, and this is my experience once more, but my experience with Pond5 regarding to their contributor customer care or contributor support, it is awful. It has been a very, very bad for me, the experience. Meaning that when I needed their support, I had to write them, and the answers are never efficient or never on the point. Now, what you have to know that at the beginning, Pond5 was letting everybody to register on their site and start to upload their or other people's material and sell them, even if the music was kind of reviewed. So there are employees who are reviewing the music, but I think they are reviewing the quality of the music, and if it really fits, if they see that there's a potential to be sold, to be licensed on their platform, and this is all what they are reviewing. So they are not verifying if the person who is uploading the track is really the owner or the creator of the composition. So that's why at the beginning there were a lot of people lot of scam artists who were registering on this platform and was selling other people's material. Nowadays, because of this problem, this scamming problem, they started to put some restrictions. So now, if you want to upload your material on Pond 5, there's a process of verification. Now, the first process is that you have to send them a scanned ID. So there's an ID verification. So I started to upload my tracks. It was very strange. I mean, the verification of the tracks, sometimes I do not understand how it's working. I do not understand the decision of the curators. I have always the same curator. It's the curator 22, and there's time when he's accepting my tracks in a genre, but then the second time or the third time is rejecting tracks that are in the same genres. But leaving that behind, generally it's okay. He's really accepting the majority of my tracks. Now, after a while, as when I'm making composition, I just like to use my own sound effects. So many times I'm recording myself the sound effects. So I thought, why not upload my sound effects also on Pond 5? So I started to upload. I made a very nice package of, for example, bathroom sounds. And I uploaded on the site, and then after a while, I got an email that my sound effects were reviewed. After opening the message, I saw that all my sound effects were rejected. It was like 200 sound effects, and all of them were rejected. And then the notice of the reason why my sound effects were rejected, apparently it was because I'm not fully vetted. So this was the first thing that I found it really strange on this platform, because this curator 22 is telling me that I'm not fully vetted, even though I sent it my ID card for them, and I was accepted on the platform already. So I contacted the contributor support service, and I got an answer that yes, it is true, I'm not fully vetted, and if I want to upload sound effects, there's more that I have to send them papers to be verified, meaning that they asked me once more the ID. They asked me to take some screenshots. How do I create them or make the composition with my DAW software, and so on and so forth, which I really found it very, very, very strange. Because even though if you are having a screenshot with your DAW, you can scam if you really want, if you are not a serious person. I think there are ways that you can act illegally. Anyway, I sent them the material that they were asking, and then after a couple of weeks, I think I got an answer from the audio director of this company. Is Mike Pace telling me that everything is okay and I'm fully vetted now and I can upload on Pond 5. So I re-uploaded material, sound effects, and but then again all my sound effects were rejected again. So when I recontacted, I think that this time I contacted the audio director directly, Mike Pace, and I asked him, so what is happening, because I would like to know, and if you do not want to accept sound effect material, it's better to communicate than to reject the material that I'm uploading. the answer of this director, and this is something that I want to pass through, is that he told me that in Pond 5 sound effects, they are really at the saturation level. They have too much already, and he didn't think that it's a good idea for me to upload the sound effects. So for you, if you are a beginner, if you are thinking on uploading material on Pond 5, I just want to pass through this information that it has been given to me by the audio director of Pond 5, Mike Pace, that they are overwhelmed already with sound effects. There's no need really for new sound effects for music material. I asked him on based on what the curators are accepting or not the tracks, and well, he told me that they kind of know what in what genre they are really full or what they really need, and if they really think that your music, one, maybe it's not a good quality, it's not a really good broadcast quality, or secondly, is taking part is part of a genre where they already have too much, in that case they will reject your tracks. So this is the two possibilities why your tracks can be rejected. My experience in Pond 5, it is interesting. I had some licenses, not so many, but obviously there's a possibility, and I see there's opportunity. I do get some licenses. As you can see here, I did get some licenses, so I started to upload the tracks at the end of May 2018, and I did upload it on daily basis, and I had licenses, so the total licenses that I had is $137.50, and this month I got some licenses also. It's $48.92, the newest licenses that I had. I see there are some Christmas songs and some lo-fi hip-hop track. Uploading on Pond 5, it's very easy. Of course, I'm using the FTP protocol. I'm uploading my tracks via FTP. And then, edit them, and the description, so tagging, metadata, is extremely simple on Pond 5. They really do not ask much about your tracks, so you have to give just the description, then tagging. You have to tag with keywords. In the keywords we'll enter everything, like moods, I don't know, instruments, what are you using, so everything in a bucket, and they are asking you if you are the owner, who is the publisher, who is the writer. They're asking you if what is the tempo of your track, if it's a fast or medium or a slow track. They are asking you with what did you do it, what have you used it, if you are a pro contributor or not, and then if their voice, if the song is an instrumental or a vocal track, and if it's loopable or not. And that's it really. So it's really simple. It's a very basic stuff that they are asking you. So generally this is really my experience on Pond 5. I won't even try to upload sound effects, but I will continue from time to time to upload audio instrumental material. I will put, as usual, the link toward this platform in my description box below, where you can have access. You will find the link toward my page on Pond 5 also, so you can see my page. Because I'm experimenting today, I have uploaded beside audio content, beside songs production music, I uploaded photos and stock footage also, to see if there's any difference, if uploading multiple material I am really more searchable. Now I can confirm you that uploading on the daily basis and so being very hyperactive on Pond 5, it really doesn't have any influence on sales. So many times when I do have licensing deals is in the period when I'm sleeping. So really I don't find any relation between the fact that I'm uploading or I have uploaded on a daily basis and the licensing deals that I got. So this is my experience so far on Pond 5. I will keep you up to date with what is happening. And I hope this was informative for you, and see you next time.